holder of over 70 national dressage titles here in Great Britain.
He's edged above 80%, Richard.
But I'm not surprised. And look how easy and unstressed the horse is at doing it. It's the most inexperienced Grand Prix horse in this championship, and it looks like it's having a dawdle around the park.
Wow!
And it's so well deserved for the nicest guy in this championship and the most modest guy, and I think it's fantastic for him to have a horse like that in his life, and it's come at this moment of time, just coming up to the London Olympics next year.
On the south bank of the River Thames, behind the Royal Naval College and the National Maritime Museum, is the Queen's House, and then the Greenwich Park Arena. 20,000 spectators packed in for the final of the team dressage. The first British competitor stamped his team's authority on the event. With this performance, Carl Hester became the first rider to score more than 80%. A strong performance would seal a first gold medal in dressage for the host nation. It would also end one of the most remarkable sequences in the Olympic Games. No German team had been beaten in this event since 1972.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Olympic medalists.
And here comes the golden team. Carl Hester with Sasha Stewart and his own wonderful utopia. My word, this man. He is certainly one of the people that has led Britain into this revolution for British dressage. But there is the man who really does deserve absolutely everything that would come his way. He is regarded as one of the best riders in the world. Carl really has been an inspiration to so many people, hasn't he? Take it all in, Carl Hester. Laurel Bechtolsheimer and Charlotte Dujardin. Tremendous performance. Carl Hester, 45 years old, but riding better than ever. Inspirational here. A wonderful, wonderful moment to win two equestrian gold medals in 2 days.